Don't look so worried. We're going to get you some help.
What if they can't?
They will.
Katrina said I tried to fob off a patient, Alice Dowsland, with the threat of a hysterectomy.
Well, how did Katrina get involved?
She found her crying in the toilets. Alice wanted to know the facts of her condition, and I made it quite clear a hysterectomy wasn't a foregone conclusion. When I suggested a therapist or counselling, she wasn't interested. She seemed fine.
Sounds like you did all you could.
Katrina said I didn't care about Alice's feelings, that I was trying to get rid of her or something.
She's never been one to keep opinions to herself.
Now, I was wrong to get angry, but every one of my patients gets my best, and Alice was no exception. I'd better go in.
Did you get the bottom of it?
Mm. Katrina sticking her oar in, by the sounds of things. Berating Mark for the way he was dealing with a patient's worries.
Sure she wasn't just trying to help?
It's hard enough. Starting a new job without being picked on by the receptionist. She was wrong to offer her help.
So you were diagnosed with MS in 94?
Yeah, I was preparing for the UK trials until I fell at the first.
What trials were they?
Shy jumping. She's really good. She could have gone to the Olympics.
The Olympics? Wow.
Could have. Horses were my life, but not anymore.
So how is your general health?
It's the same old story. Fine for a while, walking about. Then it springs an ambush and I'm back in a wheelchair. It's like my whole body doesn't know how to function. If it wasn't for David...
The treatment just isn't working, Doctor.
I've been on every antispasm drug they've got. Nothing works. I keep relapsing.
MS is difficult to control, Liz.
Really? Well, look at David. He's got MS. We have the same illness, but he drove me here, pushed my wheelchair. He's fit and active.
You can't compare yourself to David. The severity of MS is patient-specific.
I was much worse affected than Liz, but that all changed when they gave me beta interferon. It's given me a life, Doctor.
And that's all I want. I need this drug.
There's no need for him to have a go at me.
You were both angry.
He left a terrified patient sobbing in the toilets, convinced she was having a hysterectomy at the age of 30. Where was his compassion?
Maybe he got distracted.
That is no excuse to be insensitive.
He is very experienced. I can't believe he'd have acted like that.
But from what I've heard, his bedside manner leaves a lot to be desired.
If you had a problem, you should have talked to me.
Mac, I know I was in the right. He was the one who started throwing insults. Now, I can take that from patients, but not from another member of staff.
Beta interferon has been beneficial to some MS sufferers.
David's living proof of that.
Yes, but it's still early days. The drug was only launched 6 years ago. There are no guarantees that it will help you in the same way.
I'll take the risk.
There is another problem. Beta interferon is very expensive.
You can't put a price on reducing pain, giving people independence. Look how it saved me, no matter what the cost.
Not all health authorities can afford it.
My life's been torn apart. I was going to be someone, represent Great Britain at the Olympics. I lost that dream without a fight. Now all I want is to teach kids how to ride. If I spend half my life in a wheelchair, that's impossible. But with beta interferon, I can make that come true.
David's specialist is Dr. Langley.
Here's his number. Please call him.
It mightn't be the wonder cure she's looking for.
And you do know it's still a black triangle drug. There's very, very few authorities willing to foot the bill.
And ours isn't one of them.
£10,000 per year for every sufferer. It's a lot of budget going on a handful of patients.
When do you think she'll call?
When she gets some news, give her a chance.
Well, if I can't have it, they may as well throw me on the scrap heap.
Come on, Liz, this isn't like you.
Or maybe I'm being punished. Maybe this is my penance.
Come on, nobody's punishing you.
We have the same disease, but look at you. You're free, independent. You can walk, drive a car, anything you want. Every day I watch you get on with your life. Can you imagine what that's like?
Hello, Dr. Langley. Thanks for taking the time to talk to me. Mm-hmm. I have a patient who has been suffering from relapse-remitting MS for the past 7 years, and I was wondering if you could meet her for an assessment.
Unfortunately, your patient lives just outside our health authority. Now, I'm afraid there's no way she could be referred. We couldn't take a patient from Riverside. Miss O'Connor just doesn't qualify.
I wondered if Katrina was all right after yesterday.
She's upset.
So you've talked then?
I know what happened, Mark. I know what you said to her.
Katrina wouldn't let me explain.
You never leave a distressed patient, no matter what the circumstances.
I didn't know she was distressed.
You just told a young woman that she might have to give up the chance of a family.
It wasn't like that. You're making it sound a lot worse than it was.
Katrina isn't to blame here.
OK, so I reacted when I should have stayed calm.
It's Katrina that needs the apology.
I was wondering if you would talk to her.
No way. You can sort your own mess out. If you don't mind, I've got work to do.
A few streets away and they prescribe the drug.
The boundary has to be drawn somewhere.
So now your address decides what treatments you can and can't have.
There's only so much funding can go around. If it fails the value for money test, there's nothing we can do.
A healthy patient is value for money.
Absolutely. But do we give three patients a hip replacement? Or do we treat one patient with MS? We have to look beyond the individual. It's our duty to help as many people as we can.
So it's okay for some people to fall through the net?
Unfortunately, it's inevitable.
So how did things go?
She isn't eligible. The whole thing makes me feel so powerless.
I know it's frustrating, but budgets are important.
Everything shouldn't be about money.
You can only help patients within the boundaries of the system.
She seems so desperate. Another setback might just destroy her.
So, suggest other forms of medication. Show her you're committed to helping.
Is that all she deserves?
It's the best you can deliver.
I didn't need this today. Beth was waiting for me last night. Had a lot to see.
Sorry to interrupt, Helen. Can I have a quick word?
We'll talk later.
Okay. I better go and give Liz the bad news.
Strictly necessary.
I'm just staying out of his way, that's what he wants.
Katrina, it was just a misunderstanding.
Look, Alice left his room in pieces. Am I the only person to see that?
Well, maybe Alice gave you the wrong impression. Look, when I asked you if there was anything wrong, you said no. That was the time to raise your concerns.
Look, he made the mistake, Kate, not me. I'm in the right, even Mac agrees.
I've got some bad news. I called Dr. Langley, but unfortunately, there is no way that they can prescribe you the drug. You just don't qualify.
Why not?
But I don't understand. I have the symptoms it can most help, and I don't qualify.
You live near the cusp of two health authorities. In one, beta interferon is widely prescribed, but in the other, nobody gets the drug.
But I only live a few minutes from David's house.
It makes a difference.
No, there must be a mistake. I mean, she can't not qualify just because of where she lives. She deserves better.
I know it's hard to understand.
Don't patronise us, Doctor. I've lived without this drug. I know what you're denying, Liz. This is criminal.
I am sorry.
This was my chance to get back to being alive. Instead of just existing.
There are other options.
I've done my research, Doctor. For people like me, this is the only option.
I thought we'd agreed to forget about yesterday.
Sorry?
Well, Katrina says that you blame Mark for what happened.
I didn't say that. It's just that maybe he went a bit over the top.
Well, we both know what Katrina's like. At times she can test anybody's patience.
I know. But she's absolutely certain that she wasn't in the wrong.
Well, Mark's sorry for getting angry, but... Well, don't you think she asked for it, questioning his authority?
Oh, come on, Kate, we both know what she's like, but with his experience, I would have expected him to have handled it better, that's all.
How would you react if Katrina told you how to do your job? Mackie'd hate it.
I know.
I take it you're happy with the way he's settling in?
I am.
Then there's not a problem, is there?
I can't afford to wait.
There are other ways to improve your health and fitness. Better to prepare your body for an attack. What about increasing your physiotherapy sessions?
You have no idea what hell MS is to live with.
I'm trying to understand.
I once had a perfect life, just like you, before it was stolen away.
Liz, my life isn't perfect.
It looks pretty good from where I'm sitting. You want to try waking up one morning to see the world screaming by, Your vision gets so bad, it's best to keep your eyes shut, because darkness hurts, but daylight is agony.
Liz.
Then you find yourself stuck in a neurological ward for 6 weeks. After that, you're imprisoned at home for months, hanging on to the hope that tomorrow mightn't hurt so much. When I break down, these four walls are my world, my cell. That's what living with MS is all about.
Beta interferon isn't a cure.
Then what does my future hold without it?
I can't refer you to Dr. Langley. Maybe if you talk to someone, a therapist perhaps.
I don't need anyone to talk to but David. He listens.
Well, that's good.
He's the only one who understands me. Especially after Morgan left. My childhood sweetheart. We were going to get married until I got sick. Nursing wasn't exactly his forte.
I'm sorry.
Don't be. I'm sure he's happy. Found what he wanted elsewhere. One of my friends. Someone who should have been loyal, but wasn't.
And David fills the gap?
He looks after me. He gets me in return.
Is that enough? Enough for a relationship?
Illness took away my happiness, but I know I can depend on him. He'll stay loyal.
It's important to have someone. Someone to depend on.
He even asked me to try and smooth things over with you.
He did?
Yeah, tried to make out like it was all a misunderstanding. I don't know what I'd have done if he'd have talked to me like that.
Well, maybe I overreacted.
You said she was in a right state. That's no way to handle patients.
Yeah, but I can't know that he wasn't doing his job properly. Kate was right about that.
She's bound to defend him, but you were in the right.
There's a time and a place, and I let it become this slanging match.
She was crying her heart out. You had to do something.
Yeah, but I'm on thin ice here. You know, the last thing I want to be doing is causing trouble. Remember, I'm still on probation.
Yeah, well, you did what you thought was best at the time.
Yeah, maybe we both did.
NHS is a joke. How come I get the best MS drug around and Liz gets nothing? Am I depriving her of the drug she needs?
This isn't your fault.
No. I'm just lucky enough to live in the right street. How's she supposed to deal with this?
With your support?
If I could afford it, I'd buy the drug myself. That's how much she means to me.
She doesn't expect that from you.
All she ever wanted was to ride. She's lost so much.
Her life's not over. Not because she has MS and not because she can't have beta interferon.
I can't leave it here. No way. We'll talk to Dr. Langley. I'll convince him to help Liz. He can be made to understand.
Now that isn't a good idea.
Liz is just a statistic. If Dr. Langley meets her face to face, he'll change his mind.
He can't. He works in a different health authority.
We're going to confront Dr. Langley in person. She deserves better. She's going to get better.
I've given you the facts. Off the record, I don't agree with them. But I'm afraid that's the cold reality.
If beta interferon's the only way to get you back on your feet, we're going to get it.
David knows best. Thanks for your time, Doctor.
Sorry it isn't very glamorous.
I only wanted to go across the road.
I know, I just couldn't face anywhere noisy.
What happened last night?
I haven't talked to Beth in such a long time. It stirred up so many feelings.
Why did you fall out?
She's skilled at messing up people's lives. Even when she doesn't mean to. Beth was always jealous of what I had. Friends, job, husband. Especially Richard. One day I came home early. I caught them in bed together. Found out she wanted everything. Apparently it happens.
Cheating's one thing, but your sister. How'd you deal with that?
It isn't easy. So I just blotted it out. Got on with my life without either of them. And now here she is, trying to explain, to say sorry. She talked about the way we were before. I thought I didn't want her in my life, that that would be the best thing for both of us.
And now?
I don't know. I was up all night last night, playing back everything that she'd said, how much she regretted it, how her life's been empty without me.
If she cared about you, she wouldn't...
You don't know, Beth. She's impulsive, vulnerable. I was the one who always looked after her. Beth just wanted to be me.
Don't make excuses for her.
I've done that all her life. But I saw the way she looked at me. She wants her sister back.
But do you want her back?
I don't know. Maybe it is time to forgive. Beth is desperate to salvage what we had.
If you're not ready...
It's not going to be easy to put her off. Beth's got a job. At the leather bar. Nah. She's here to stay. She's here to be forgiven.
Dr. Langley.
Am I scheduled to see you today, Mr. Montague?
No, but we need to talk to you about beta interferon. Liz needs a prescription.
Look, I can't see people directly. You have to be referred through a GP.
I've been to my GP. Dr. Carlisle called you earlier. You said I lived in the wrong area.
Miss O'Connor, yes, I remember.
It's not right. I know you're a good doctor, you've helped me, but now you've got to help Liz. She can't miss out on this.
David, it's not that easy. I explained all this...
Make it easy. Look, just a few minutes of your time, that's all we ask.
I can give you 2 minutes. I expected Dr. Carlisle to have explained to you that I can't treat you. Didn't she make this clear?
No. That's why we came. I really need this drug, Dr. Langley. It's the only thing that can help me.
I know this is difficult to accept.
You could give her my supply.
David, it doesn't work like that.
This has changed my life. Liz deserves it more than me.
Look, those are the rules. You can't be referred because of where you live. It's just not possible.
How is that fair? I'm only a couple of streets out. We're talking about yards here.
There is nothing I can do.
We better go. Somebody might really need your help.
Yes, Cathy, what is it?
Kate told me about your argument.
Ah, yes. Really showed myself up, didn't I?
Sounds like she was out of line as well.
I was just trying to defend myself. You know, got a bit out of control.
Sometimes Katrina gets involved where she shouldn't.
I would never have left Alice if I thought she was in distress.
Sometimes it's easy to misjudge a patient's reaction to bad news. Calmness and shock often look the same.
Don't think Mac was too impressed. After that thing with Faith, the last thing he wants is a war in reception.
Go and see him. Explain what happened. His bark's worse than his bite. You'll have seen worse in the army.
Yeah, sure have.
If Dr. Carlisle had been clear, then I wouldn't have had an enraged couple begging me for an unavailable course of treatment. I suggest you check up on her patient etiquette. I'm not here to justify health authority drug policy or to fill in the blanks left by a Riverside doctor. I'm not here to do Dr. Carlisle's job.
Here you go. This isn't over yet, Liz.
I'm not financially viable. They just don't care about me.
Don't say that. I care. When I look in the mirror every morning and see the changes this has brought me, there's no way you're missing out.
But what can we do?
Let's complain to the Department of Health. Our MP, we can prove that they're wrong.
I don't have the energy.
This is worth fighting for, Liz. For both of us.
For both of us?
You know how I feel.
Then you'll do anything for me?
Just ask.
The situation shouldn't have blown up like that. Dr. Langley had every right to be annoyed.
It's Liz's right to be annoyed.
Well, charging off to Hardwick Grange wasn't the answer.
Then what was? Liz and David wanted someone to blame.
Yeah, well, with situations as sensitive as this, we have to be extremely careful. We don't want it reflecting badly on the surgery. Reputations are important.
And the NHS is rapidly getting the reputation for denying patients the treatments they need.
I know it's frustrating for you.
That's nothing to what Liz will be feeling.
The National Institute for Clinical Excellence has a difficult enough job balancing the budget. And it is a balancing act, Jude. One that sometimes goes wrong.
NICE was set up to end postcode prescribing. In the end, it makes no difference.
Oh. We've been having these funding problems for years. The NHS does have its limitations. You haven't failed, Liz.
But I still can't help her, can I?
Yes. Mac, can I have a word?
Of course, yeah, come in.
We're here to see Dr. Carlisle. Is she available, please?
I'm afraid surgery's almost over. Could I book you another appointment?
My name's Liz O'Connor. I spoke to Dr. Carlisle earlier, but I really need to see her again.
I'll see if she's free.
I know yesterday I was out of order.
Well, it's not what I expected.
No. No, since I've started here, I don't think things have gone as either of us would have expected. I was wrong to mix my personal life with work, that thing with Faith. It was irresponsible.
Hey, sometimes things happen.
Yeah, well, it's the story of my life. I'm absolutely hopeless with women. And now after that Katrina argument, I'd understand if you thought things weren't working out.
Well, you're not thinking of leaving, are you?
Maybe I'm not the doctor you thought I was.
Well, I'm glad you came back in. I heard things didn't go too well at Hardwick Grange.
We should have listened to you.
Well, I've been doing some research, looking into alternative forms of treatment. It won't be beta interferon, but...
I've come to tell you I'm changing my GP. It's not you. I know you've tried, but I've got some good news. David asked me to move in. I agreed.
And when did you decide this?
Circumstances decided it for us. My situation is changing for the better. I'll be joining David's doctors. They can refer me.
It's a big step. Have you really thought it through?
Where David lives, postcodes aren't a problem.
But moving to get a prescription, that's no reason to set up home together.
It makes perfect sense. David's good enough.
But do you love him?
It's not as simple as that.
No, I think it is, Liz. You can't use him to get the drug. What about the future?
We could be good together.
And if you're not? Are you going to dump him just like your fiancé dumped you?
That's not going to happen.
Liz, living a lie might be a lot harder than you think.
It's my life, Doctor. Sometimes you have to work around the rules. He wants to look after me. I want to let him.
Well, good luck.
You helped.
About earlier, I shouldn't have talked to you like that.
You care about her. It was natural.
She means the world to me.
Is that why you asked her to move in?
There's more to us than just getting this drug. I'm lucky to have her.
She's the lucky one.
Relationships are different for everybody, Doctor. But the way she makes me feel, it's beyond anything I ever dreamed of.
But moving in...
This is just... the only way... I get to have her. If she's using me, I don't care.
Then I hope you both get what you want.
I know we will. Thank you. Come on. Let's get you home.
In the army, I wasn't used to being reprimanded by a subordinate.
Look, here at Riverside, we try to be a team, you know? Help each other.
And I never wanted to get Katrina into trouble.
Well, sometimes it's easy for things to get out of hand. I mean, your professionalism being called into question. Well, I wouldn't have accepted it.
Yes, I overstepped the mark. But I shouldn't have let it get personal.
Listen, Mark, I'm really glad you came to see me. And the last thing I want is to lose you.
And what about all the hassle I've caused?
Well, I never took all that stuff with Faith that seriously. She'll come round in her own time, and as for Katrina, well, her heart's in the right place. She's just got a lot to learn. Give it a few days, it'll be ancient history.
So everything's okay, then?
You're a good doctor, Mark. Just get on with that, eh?
Thanks, mate.
Yeah,